Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'da habatifillah. A question was asked, assalamu alaikum akhi. Inshallah, I'm going to finish secondary school by the end of this year, but I don't have really what I, but I don't really know what I want to do. But I plan to seek knowledge, etc., getting a good grasp of the Arabic language, but I need to find something where I can have the stability in order for me to get married. What is a good career with an Islamic lifestyle where I can pray my 5 daily prayers and go to Jumu'ah once a week on Fridays? So this is a question from our brother in Australia. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us in him, preserve us in him, forgive us in him, guide us in him. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. As far as a career, those issues are things you're going to have to find out what you are good at. And since you are a young man, bi'idhnillah ta'ala, you have a lot of opportunity to do. What I would suggest and firmly believe in, and wish I had people to encourage me to have done this when I was younger, is to be independent and have a business. And strive to gain the skills to be independent and have a business. Then you meet your criterion right there. A business person, and I know one particular brother that the last time I lived in Yemen, he would come back and forth. He was my neighbor. In fact, he rented a building and I was even a tenant of his, and he's from America. May Allah bless him and preserve him. Had multiple wives, had his wives set up there in Yemen, go back and forth to America, do some talib al-ilm. And this was at his leisure, more or less. He travels the world, he does what he needs to do because he is an independent businessman. And his education came out of the prison system and came from the streets of hard knocks and how he was developing his character to be a go-getter. And this is imperative and important that we know that you have to build yourself. You have to be confident. You have to have goals, and you have to not let anyone distract you from those goals. That's what I will say in general. And I recently came across something, and I'm going to do a video independently of this, talking about some of those issues, the importance of setting goals, and the importance of not letting detractors destroy your goals and destroy you from traversing the path. If it's a path of Islamic knowledge, go for it. Tawakkal ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Strive. If you want to be a talib al-ilm and you want to make that sacrifice, then don't let anyone deter you from that. Bi'idhnillah ta'ala. Tawakkal ala Allah. Tawakkal ala Allah wa fi'l asbab. I'timad ala Allah wa fi'l asbab. Tawakkal means to rely solely, make efforts to achieve what you're trying to achieve. Itimad al-Allah, and putting your total trust and leaving your affairs and leaving the ending with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my advice is strive your independence. Don't do something that is going to make you miserable. What I mean is to get stuck in a career, to get stuck in a simple profession, even if it allows you to go overseas and seek knowledge. That's great. And I know many people who have done what I've done to be able to teach English or things related to that, careers that they are not really relevant to what they studied or what is their passion, and have been stuck in that, but it's allowed for them to do some talib al-ilm. That's great. It's a means. But do you really want to get to a point in life where you are miserable and you don't want to be stuck doing that stuff anymore? So this is why I say it's important to do something that's going to give you some financial independence. And nothing can do that really except for hopefully a successful business. Find something. Sit under the tutelage of somebody. Learn and study. You know, the tools now are infinite of gaining knowledge about businesses and the various opportunities. So search and learn and do something that you kind of enjoy, and something that can either pay the bills if you're going to work for somebody else, that it pays decent. But don't go to a career that's not going to give you much in what you're trying to achieve. So I hope that is something that can be of benefit to you. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.